next on G4 Tech TV. The Screensavers, followed by Cheat at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, and then at Cinema Tech.
Tons of good stuff on today's show, one of them being G4TV.com's Tina Wood is here as our co-host.
That's right, Kevin Rose. Coming up tonight, we're going to show you how to become an online DJ, and Yoshi's going to show off his new robot.
Very cool. Plus, we've got a bunch of vintage computers, and we're going to be playing Mystery Bag or Netcam. So don't go anywhere. We're going to be back in exactly 3 minutes.
2:59.
You ready?
2:58. This is the rehearsal, right?
A lightning strike in Buffalo and a lesson on the power play. Hi and welcome to G4 Sports NHL Update. I'm Jim Fox. He's Luke Robitaille. He can score. And Luke, before we get going tonight and talk about scoring and pick your brain a little bit, check out the app. Only one game tonight, but we love it. A lot of offense. In Buffalo, the Sabres play host to the Stanley Cup champs from Tampa Bay. Their motto, safe is death. Well, no save tonight. The Lightning strikes for the visitors with four straight goals on their way to a 9-5 win over the Sabres. Luke, you and I played in some high-scoring games with the Los Angeles Kings, and I think we know that coaches hate them, players love them.
We played in a lot of them. Our coaches didn't like us. No, it's great for a player, and I think it is great for the fans, but coaches would rather, I think, have those 2-1 games where everybody plays the system, because a lot of times when it's a high-scoring game, you don't really play the system the way it's supposed to be.
Well, talking about system, Tampa Bay picked up 2 goals on the power play tonight. Luke, you've always been a great power play player. What's the key to scoring all those goals on the power play?
I think the key to scoring on the power play is, first of all, you got to outwork the other team, even though you're 5-4, and puck movement is really important. And, you know, if you're willing to pay a price in front of the net, you'll score a lot of goals.
That's a big point, Luke, because the players are bigger now. They're stronger. You've been around a long time, but they're still tough. How do you stay in front when someone's trying to move you?
Well, you got to be a little bit cuckoo, you know.
That's you gotta, okay for you.
When you know a guy's bigger than you, you're still going there. But I think the reward is so great. I think a lot of guys are still doing it. But, you know, there is a price to pay, because it's a battle in front of the net, and it's a battle for positioning and so forth. But, like, when you get that goal or a big goal and so forth, it's always worth it.
Hit, goal, smile.
That's right.
The way it looks.
Let's
take a look right now at some keys to a successful power play.
Okay. Well, I think you can see here, I think the keys, Dallas is always shooting from the center of the ice. And most of their shots is either in the top of their circle or in the middle, and they have traffic in front of the net. So they're moving the puck well, and they always have one guy, a lot of times two, and you can see the way it goes. If there's a rebound, they 2-1 the defenseman for the rebound. And that's really the key on the power play, to have traffic in front of the net and the shot coming from the middle as much as possible.
Outnumber the opposition in front. If there's a loose puck, you're going to get it. He's picked up a lot of that.
That's right.
That's it for tonight. You'll find stats, standings, and more on our website. Check it out, g4techtv.com. A lot of action, a lot of scores, a lot of goals. Luke Robitaille's done it all his NHL career. We'll see you next time.
A lot of fun. Good night.
Coming up tonight, be an online DJ, but a really, really cool online DJ. Plus, Yoshi shows you how to build your very own fighting robot. And we'll take you back in time. How far are we going back? Way back to the very beginning of the computer revolution. Live from Studio 3, just west of the 405, that's LA Speak. It's the Screensavers!
I'm Kevin Rose, and G4TV.com's Tina Wood is here with me today, everybody.
So excited!
What did you do to Alex?
I killed him.
Alex is dead. No, Alex is not dead.
Yes, he is.
But there's some people clapping. That's not
They're
right.
Like, score, man. No, but I did realize, I think I'm taller than Alex. Like, there was like some phone books and stuff here, and I'm, he's just a little guy.
He's actually like 5'2".
Cute little guy.
He comes up to about right about here.
Yeah,
I mean, actually.
He does. Smart though, and very, very funny.
He's shooting a Dell commercial today.
That is a score, man. That's a score.
How do you get to do something like that? A sellout is what I'm saying.
Residuals, man. That's what I'm saying.
That sounds good to me, actually. If Dell gave me that, I'd probably be like, yes, indeed.
Yeah, exactly.
Done deal.
Later screensavers. Hello, Dell.
That's right. Now, Sarah, of course, is in the nook hanging out.
Hi, guys. Hi, Tina.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great because usually I'm the only girl on the show. And
I
now
know.
We've got estrogen squashing Kevin.
It's an estrogen sandwich.
It's going to be one of these. You see my new purse?
Yeah.
I mean, Yoshi's here, thank goodness.
Yeah, you better get out fast. Get out fast.
Yoshi's here. Now, there's big news. I don't know if you guys have heard about this one, but Valve has announced that Half-Life 2 will be released on November 16th.
This is such huge news. I mean, it was slated to come out in September.
Right.
We talked about, but someone stole the source code. Not cool, Kevin.
I didn't do it. Don't blame me for this one.
Not cool at all. But this game, 6 years in development. We've been waiting forever. I mean, it really was an innovative first-person shooter. Really relied on the AI. This game really brought AI into the picture in a way that we had never seen it before. But it does kind of come on the heels of a lot of other games. You got Halo 2, you got Metroid Prime, Echoes. There's a ton of other games coming at the same time, so I am a little bit curious.
So I should start saving right now because November is going to be the month to drop the cash.
Oh, it's going to be like $400. I don't have $400. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of money. But the game, as opposed to the first one relying on AI, this one is going to be all about the physics. And they're saying PC Gamer gave it like a 98%.
And you're saying that's kind of unheard of for a PC gamer,
yeah,
right?
I mean, these guys, you have to be hard on video games. You can't give everything a 10, you know, or 100%. So they're saying this game is simply the best game on the planet.
Well, we are very excited about that.
Oh, absolutely.
Can't wait.
You play the original Half-Life?
Yeah, I played a little bit. I love Counter-Strike.
Counter-Strike's a blast. And that's the other thing, too, is now the whole mod community's like, oh, yeah, I'm
going
to be busy for a long time.
Yeah, I thought Doom 3 was going to be the big game of the year, but this seems to be kind of like better engine, a little bit.
Definitely, they're using the Havoc engine. You know what I mean? That's something we really haven't seen before. Doom 3 was... it was a great game for like the first couple of hours and it got really repetitive. I don't think this game gets repetitive at all.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I can't wait to check it out.
Absolutely. Very much looking forward to it. But as we talk about video games, product placement in video games, Nielsen and Activision have sort of teamed up with the game Thug 2 to sort of see how...
tell me about this.
Yes, how consumers sort of adhere to advertising in video games.
So this is just a way for ad companies or video game companies to make more money, right? They kind of watch kids as they play, and if they grab certain types of cars or certain products in a game...
Exactly, like, and I think Chrysler's in on it, too. So are you going to go for, like, a Chrysler, or are you going to go for, like, a Chevy? And so they're sort of doing this, like, focus group, guys between the ages of, like, 18 and 35, and what it's going to do is it's going to really give game companies a lot more money to make video games, which is hopefully... going to keep the prices down for us, but...
I have a feeling they're just going to pocket the extra
cash. They could just pocket it, too.
I have yet to see a game where, like, hey, we're making so much money, we're going to give it to you for $20.
Yeah, exactly. But we did talk about how funny it's like if you're playing, like, Madden, and all of a sudden, like, Tom Brady goes back for a snap and stops and says, hold on, and takes a sip of his Gatorade.
That would suck.
And then he's full
of... I don't want to be playing, like, World of Warcraft and see, like, a huge Pepsi ad in a dungeon or something
like that.
That would be...
Or Max Payne's walking around in his Hanes underwear, you know, and it's
No.
Well, we'll see.
We're going to see what comes of that.
It is, you know what? It's evolution. It's evolution and a revolution, so we'll see how it works out.
Very cool. Now, also, have I told you about Firefox?
You have, and I'm actually a little bit more interested to hear a little bit more about
that. Do we have any fans of Firefox, the browser, in the audience?
Afraid to say that I had never actually even heard of Firefox because I'm not a real...
Well, I'm going to convert you right now.
Yeah, I'm not a huge techie person, more of a gamer, but why don't you tell me a little bit about it?
Well, Firefox is this alternative browser to Internet Explorer, and the reason why people are moving to this is because it's so much better than IE. It has built-in pop-up blocking. It has better security than Internet Explorer. There's, like, tab browsing. There's a bunch of different stuff that you can add into this.
But I love my pop-ups.
No. You do not love your pop-ups. Everybody hates pop-ups. But the big news today is they're going to purchase an ad in the New York Times. Now, this is the first time something like this has happened in the open source community, and it's all run by volunteers. So it's volunteers that have set this up, and they're actually going out and buying a $100,000 ad.
Wow.
So what they're doing is they're asking for donations.
Okay.
So you can contribute either $30 or $10 if you're a student. But the coolest part is that they're going to list all the names of everyone that donated in the ad, in the New York Times.
So your name, because you donated $30, is going to be in the New York Times.
Yeah, so I put $30 down, and now my ad's going to be on, or my name's going to be on their huge list of names, and then they're going to talk about Firefox and why it's better, and why the community got together to purchase this ad.
So because I look at that, and I use Internet Explorer, but you were saying it has all these security issues, and I was kind of like, I mean, it looks really neat, but as someone who's not really technical savvy, I'm not sure what it would do for me. Or I don't know if I feel more secure by just using Firefox.
Well, it's just, I'm going to have to give you a rundown of all the different features that it has. But you were the one that was telling me the other day you had like a virus or something like that on your computer.
I get viruses like twice a day.
So that might be part of the problem.
Computer viruses, though.
Well, spyware and adware, things like that, they can sneak themselves in. There's been a ton of security exploits that have been announced for Internet Explorer. So a lot of people are like, I'm done with being hacked. I don't want my information exposed. I'm worried about, you know, the security of the browser. I mean, think about how many things you do on your browser.
Well, that does scare me.
You buy products.
All my online banking. Constantly putting my credit card through there. So security definitely is an issue. I just haven't thought about it that much because, quote, unquote, nothing's gone on stolen yet.
Until something like that happens.
Exactly.
And then you consider changing. But it's best to do it ahead of time. So.
Yeah. No, that sounds good.
I'm going to convert you, though.
Well, I want to put my name in the New York Times. Can I, like, put $10 onto yours?
Yeah, we want to tell everybody. Well, there's only 2,500 spots. So right now they have 1,100 people have signed up to do it. So we want to tell everybody, go do it now. Spreadfirefox.com is the name of the URL you're going to go to, and you can pay for it and get your name in the New York Times.
That's pretty cool.
Help out Firefox.
Yeah, totally. That sounds great. Well, tonight we've got a great show. We're going to play the first video game ever created, or at least you and Sarah are.
This is going to be fun.
Yes, and one lucky audience member might go home with something cool when we play Mystery Bag or Netcam.
Mystery Bag or Netcam. Who wants to play? Yeah. There's some people who want to play today. And Yoshi is in the lab today. Yoshi's got some cool stuff going on.
Yeah, I got my robot bag. We teased it a little bit yesterday, but today I'm going to show off what this guy can do, kind of talk about building him and how you can get into it. It's really, really cool. I mean, he walks. He can get up.
You were saying you were going to make him do, like, flips or something, though,
I was trying to get him to do a cartwheel, but you'll have to, you know, stay tuned after the break and see, because I've been working on that.
Very cool.
If he busts out with a cartwheel, that's nuts.
I know. Did you see the one yesterday that was kind of walking around and dancing?
Yeah, for $50,000, it better be able to do more than dance.
It was more than that.
Better make me breakfast, make me dinner, pay my bills. All right.
You're absolutely right, though.
All
right. That's what I want to realize.
Sarah, what's going on over there?
Well, you know, I haven't done a Windows tweak in a while. Windows tweaks, things I can do in Windows to make it run better. So I'm going to bring back an old favorite, something I did about a year ago. Bringing it back.
Old school.
Bring it back.
Recycling.
Old school. Yeah, it's good. It's recycling. Yeah. It's a little less work for me, but I think everybody's going to benefit from it. But, of course, on the show, we always want your live calls. You know the number, but I'm going to tell you again anyway. It's 800-839-7880. Or, of course, you can email us through our web form at g4techtv.com/asktss.
Very cool.
That's right. There are so much more screensavers still to come. Later, we're going to have some tips for becoming an online DJ. And after the break, Yoshi's going to show off his latest toy. So stay tuned because we're coming right back.
Brought to you by Circuit City. For the hottest new technology, think Circuit City. Just what I needed.
Two letters. TV. Simple, right? Except these days there's HDTV, EDTV.
We could get an LCD TV.
If we don't get help, we'll end up with NOTV.
At CircuitCity.com, you can research all the hot new products, compare ratings, even buy online. Plus, find a huge selection of all the top brands every day. Circuit City.
Get off me! Get off me! God!
Feel the power of the new Nokia N-Gage QD from Singular. Insane graphics and the latest titles. Get yours at Singular Wireless, rated T for teens.
First there was pizza, and it was good. Then there was something entirely different. The new Double Melt Pizza from Domino's. Layer upon layer of cheese and
crust.
Excuse me.
Do we have to do this every time we order?
Why not?
Domino's new Double Melt Pizza. Layer upon layer of flavor. With a creamy blend of cheeses and herbs between two thin crusts. Buy your medium one-topping Double Melt Pizza for $9.99 and get any second medium for just $5 more. Get the door. It's Domino's new Double Melt Pizza.
It will summon you. It will challenge you. It will consume you. Mortal Kombat Deception. Online for PlayStation 2 and Xbox. Rated mature.
Put a spell on you. Because you're mine. I put a spell on you.
Ever wondered what it's really like to be a soldier?
What do you got?
I have a sit rep from Alpha Company.
BG, ready to be verified. Verified!
Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, even what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY now and get this free t-shirt and your free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
Tonight on the G-Spot, Cinematech turns up the heat as playmate Deanna Brooks takes us deep inside Playboy, the mansion.
Your dreams just came true?
And chimes in on the most sultry cinemas.
How'd you like that tease?
It's skin to win, baby. Find the G-Spot every weeknight starting at 10.
Now, yesterday, we had Sony's Curio on to give you a glimpse of the future of robot technology. Wasn't that cool?
Sweet.
It was sweet, but it cost millions of dollars in R&D. But, Yoshi, you're here today to show us some stuff that's not going to cost us $1 million.
No. I mean, we all like robots.
We love robots.
As a little kid, robots are the toy. I mean, you want robots to smash and crash and just, like, these, you ever have, like, the Rock'em Sock'em?
Oh, dude,
like,
these are my favorite. I will rock you in this.
Okay, all right.
Like, let's get it.
All right, you're dead.
Okay, we need to overclock these so that they just, like, drop each other.
Exactly. But, I mean, these guys are a blast. We need a good game, but they're just a simple,
yeah, these are pretty basic. These are, like, $10.
Then they got, like, these RoboSapiens that came out.
Now, this is the one we gave away in one of our mystery bags.
Yeah, these are cool. I mean, they walk around. He turns. He makes a lot of ugh noises. But they do, like, you know, they'll hit you, that kind of stuff.
That's cool. Yeah, you were making him pick up stuff, right?
Yeah, I was trying to get him to pick up that car. Let's see if we can get him to.
Oh, nice. And there. He
doesn't have a good grip on
it. There's a reason he's $20.
Well, he has it's like $100. They have a special
cup
that comes with for him to pick up. And I think that's the only thing he can pick up.
Oh, nice. He's cool, though.
So we'll put him over there. But today, I wanted to show this guy. Do you remember the Robo Olympics where we had the Robo One competition?
Yeah.
These guys are all balancing and doing the little push competitions. It's fighting, but the goal is to knock them over.
Right.
So they finally have a kit you can get here now. This is a Japanese kit.
Okay.
It's from Kondo. It's the KHR1. A company called Sozbots.com sells them here.
Very cool. So this looks so hard to put together. Look at the backside
really
of this
easy,
guy.
It was easy, actually. I mean, it looks really complicated. There's all this wiring.
Just a bunch of servos, right, all over the place?
Yeah, pretty much a bunch of servos, all the wires. You just kind of get every little screw and bracket you got to put together, and it's not that typical.
How long did it take you to put something like this together?
About 3 hours.
Oh, that's not too bad.
Putting it together was actually pretty easy, as long as you can follow instructions, which they come in Japanese. So you have to download.
That's a little difficult.
Well, you have to download. There's an English one on their website. You can download it. English version of the program. It's easy enough. You just have to look at a PDF.
Okay, so you have your computer fired up right here, right?
Well, that's how we control it. Like, I got this little interface over here.
Through USB?
It's actually serial, but you can see you can, like, move individual things.
Oh, that's cool. You're just twisting the little sliders right there.
Exactly. But I got a couple little programs loaded up here. Let's go to this demo.
So you program the moves in. Is that how you get
them to program the moves in. So it's not autonomous. So you have to tell it, okay, move this one here, move this one here. Okay, then move. It's kind of like stop motion animation.
Right. Then you save it as a file, and then it runs through that sequence again.
Exactly.
Oh, very cool.
Now, this particular kit, actually, you have to just tell it where to go. There's another kit that they have that has the red servos where you can pose it and then get the information from it so it knows
that'd be
where
cool.
it was.
So it keeps track of where they're turned, right? And then it puts it in the computer.
Exactly. So let's see if this guy works here.
So what is he going to do now? Right now he's dead.
Well, right now he's getting ready. He's going to get up here in a second.
Flexing his arms out.
It's looking a little slow here. What the heck? And Murphy's Law has taken form. Yes. Let's reset him. Oh, I did the wrong routine. That's why.
Is he running Windows?
Yeah, he is running Windows.
Could be. That happens with those ones.
Well, let's check out some B-roll. I got some clips that have them doing some pretty amazing things that I actually couldn't quite get them. This is a cartwheel. I couldn't quite figure out how to get it to work right. I could get him to get to there and fall over.
Oh, nice.
And that's about all
that's
I could
cool.
get him to do.
So they won't share their programs? They're like, no, I program these moves. You can't have them.
Well, this was actually at some Singapore hobby show. So someone had taken one of these kits and programmed it, and this was their demonstration.
That's
it wasn't
awesome.
From the company. And he's doing a little soccer kick there.
He looks like that Transformer, the Ghetto Blaster one.
The Megatron.
Yeah.
Not Megatron.
No,
with
the tape deck in the front, yeah.
And, you know, every robot needs some exercise, so some push-ups. You know, you got to have some robot push-ups.
That's awesome. Make him do push-ups.
Well, let me see if I can make him get up, because this is really frustrating me that he won't get up now.
Okay. Oh, there he goes. Whoa.
There he goes. And
nice.
gets that.
That's awesome.
So that's pretty cool. And he's gonna take a few steps. He's gonna walk. And the walking was really hard because you actually got to like tell him, okay, you got to lean a little bit, but not too much, and then lean over and get a little temperamental.
He's a little gimpy.
He's a little gimpy.
That's cool. How much did he cost?
He won't fall off. He's going to stop here in about one step.
He almost
went. Okay, now he's going to stop. Those go for about $1,650. They're not too bad.
$1,600.
Look, the Ivo. Look, think of it that way.
That's
those
true.
Go for about $1,800. And is he going to do it? Yes, and he
does
his balance test. I was worried about that one. He kept doing that.
Oh, there he goes. That's cool though. That's a fun project for sure.
Oh, it's totally.
I got to play with this guy a little bit later. For more information on the Kondo robot. It's his name, right? Kondo. All right, you can go to their website, thescreensavers.com. We have links right there. Now, still to come, we're going to take a look back at computing history with some vintage machines. And up next, have you ever wanted to create your own radio station and make people dance? Up next, we're going to show you how you can be a DJ online and crank out the MP3s to the world when the screensavers continue.
I have important information on how you can earn more money in the IT industry. Right now, businesses are desperate to hire certified IT professionals to secure their networks. You can fulfill this demand and make a great salary by getting IT certified now with Smart Certify Direct's fast and easy training courses. Their self-paced online training for MCSE, Cisco, and A+ certification allows you to study whenever and wherever you want, with 24-hour access to certified instructors, all with a 100% money-back certification guarantee. And right now, you can take a free training course title by visiting www.smartcertifiedirect.com or by calling 1-877-TRAINING and mentioning code TECHTV. There's no other obligation. That's on the web at www.smartcertifiedirect.com or toll-free at 1-877-TRAINING. Get your free course today.
Real-world testing we do here at Honda Safety Research Center enables us to design products that provide exceptional protection for drivers, passengers, and pedestrians. Because what we learn in here makes a difference out there.
Weekends are special. So Enterprise has special weekend rates from $9.99 a day. Rent Friday to Monday from just $9.99 a day. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
What are your dreams? Do they include playing video games? Or making video games? Or both? Stop dreaming. Pick up the phone, call Collins College, and start a career doing what you love in the new game design program. Call 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200.
Worms and germs can attack your computer.
Something's wrong with your computer, and you've tried everything.
Try this.
One quick click. Velos will keep your entire system virus-free, safe, and secure.
With Velos, to make it faster than the day you got it.
Visit Velos.com.
And make it quick.
If you even think you're slowing down, get a free virus scan at Velos.com and make it fast.
I should be hosting X-Play! I know every name of every creator of every major game released in the last 25 years! It's okay.
X-Play, tonight at 11.
Now, Tina, have you ever done any DJing?
A little bit, like we were just talking about down in Ibiza.
Yeah?
Yeah, during some summers.
Nice.
No, I've
You've never tried it?
I actually have never tried it. That's not true. I did do it once, and I just remember going, and there being a big scratch right inside the record. So at that point, I figured it wasn't really my thing.
Well, this isn't as hardcore as the turntable style, but this is going to show you how. I'm going to show you how to create an online, like, you can be an online DJ.
So, like, if I have a party, you can, like, bring in your computer?
And you could even share this. Yeah, I can bring your computer in, but you're also going to be able to share it with anybody else in the world. So if
awesome.
People want to connect to you over the internet,
listen
to what you're listening to. Yeah,
that's
really cool
to download. So when you go work out, I can be like, hey, I'm going to listen to Kevin Rose's, like, 13.
You can tap into it if you have something like an internet-enabled device.
Very cool.
I'll show you how to set it up right here. It's called. It's a little application by AnalogX.
Okay.
And it's called Simple Server Shout. We're going to run it just like this, and it's very straightforward. You just double-click it, it launches. The server is now running. And we're going to click start right there. And then you launch your Winamp.
Okay.
And the Winamp has the plugin, the Shoutcast plugin, already installed. So now what's going to happen is once we hit play on here, it's going to go ahead and start streaming. Let's see here with the encoder. You can see that it's sending bytes of information out right now to the world. So it lists the entire of what I'm playing and my station in the Shoutcast library so that people that have Winamp, so all you have to do is you could go back to your desk or you could be at home or wherever you are in the world and connect to my stream and then listen to whatever I'm playing for you.
We're so connected.
Isn't that awesome?
So cool.
So basically it has a couple of options here I want to show you about. You can go into the encoder here and choose how you want to send the stream out. So I'm going to say I want it to go out as an MP3. You can choose the bit rate. 128 is a good example. That's like what all the iTunes stuff is encoded
and
at.
And as you go through, it doesn't look that complicated. It looks pretty simple.
It's very straightforward, especially with the server and side of things. Now, if you want to talk, you can also have a microphone. So what I've done is I've hooked up this microphone to the back of the PC.
Okay.
And you can push, if you see here, we choose the microphone input. And there's a little button here that says push to talk.
So you might say like, hey, this is going out to all the ladies tonight.
I wouldn't say that, but okay. You could if you like.
No, it'll be more. You could do that more than I do.
I definitely wouldn't get into that.
Or pillow talk from Kevin Rose.
Hello,
or something.
Welcome to. No.
Exactly.
So that's all there is to it. You push to talk, and that's going to break the stream. And actually, what it does is I can pull up the volume here, and notice on the little sliders off here to the left, when I push to talk, it lowers. Oops, that put down right in front there. It's going to lower the volume. It slides out the volume, so it kind of fades the song out while it's fading in your microphone. So it's pretty cool.
So that's very cool. So it really is totally, there's like a transition period. Mm-hmm. Music goes down, DJ comes up,
and then back out again. You can stream now. It all depends on how fast your internet connection is. If you have a really fast computer, then you can or not a fast computer, but a fast internet connection, the more people you can serve. This is great for friends.
How popular is it right now?
Shoutcast is huge.
Awesome.
Extremely popular, completely free. Now, other computers have to have, of course, Winamp installed. We want to tell you that as well. And you can get all the links to this stuff at thescreensavers.com.
I'm going to have to go there.
Very cool stuff.
Yeah, it sounds like a plan.
Yeah. Now it is time for a live call. Who do we have on the phone? Sean joins us on the G4 Tech TV Netcam Network from Buffalo, New York.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, Sean. How are you?
What's up, Sean?
Great. Just waiting for the Yankee game to start over here.
I tell you, boy, that game last night, woo!
That was crazy.
That was a doozy.
I've been watching in high def. It's great.
Oh, that's incredible. All right.
Tina, great job today, by the way.
Hey, thanks. I totally appreciate it.
Can't wait to see more of you.
And you're doing great so far, too.
Yeah.
Sean's
can you leave
little,
us alone, actually?
Did you hear what Sean said? He said he can't wait to see more
of
you.
Sounds like a plan.
Awesome.
Hey, Sean, how's it going? It's Kevin.
Hey, Kevin. Dude, what's going on?
What's up, man?
All right, Sean, what do you want to talk about?
All right, so I just started here at NYU.
Nice.
Just hitting some clubs and bars and things.
Right.
But I'm sort of having a problem. I can't find any girls that I'm really interested in, so I want to know if you guys have any online dating sites in mind that I could take a look at.
Online dating?
Yeah.
Well,
right.
Sean,
yeah. I know.
Ooh.
I'm sort of afraid to refer you for some reason. I don't know why. No, that's not true.
We can hook him up with some online dating sites.
Yeah, no, absolutely. There's Match.com, which is obviously, I don't know, that's probably got the most singles.
Most users, yeah.
Yeah. But it does cost money.
Right. Now, it's free to start a profile, but then when you want to contact someone, that's when you have to start spending some cash.
That's just like going on a date. Be prepared to spend money if you want to date women.
That's right.
The way it works.
But thousands and thousands of dollars.
Now, there's Friendster, which is like started off as like your friends being like, okay, I might like send an email to Kevin and then he can join Friendster. And that's become really, really popular. But it's not really about dating, although a lot of people have gotten dates from Friendster, and the good thing about that is it's free. So, Sean, if you go to Friendster.com...
I'm on Friendster right now. This is really cool.
Are you?
I'm on Dan's profile. He logged us up, and he has two friend requests. Let's see if there are any girls.
No, don't go into profiles.
From Adam. Adam wants to be his friend.
Are there Yankee fans on there?
Okay, sorry, Dan. We'll go into your profile for me. Dan's like, no. My girlfriend might be watching. Dan was freaking out there for a second. Sorry about that, Dan. The last one we want to tell you about also is wingwoman.com.
Now, this one's really cool. And the whole theory behind this, Kevin, is that, like, if a guy's out with a bunch of chicks at a bar, women are sort of more apt to paying attention to them, which is really true.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's like $50 an hour. It's a minimum of 3 hours. And what you do is say, I would go with you.
Right.
Say you had a problem, and I would be your wing woman. So we'd go to a bar, and I'd say, hey, I'd also help you scout. And I might say, hey, that girl over there, like, she's really, you know, might work out. Let me go over there, let me talk to her.
So you kind of, you're the icebreaker.
Yeah,
then.
Like, I'm the meteor. I'll go over there and, you know, maybe I'll send her a drink on her behalf, or I'll go talk to her. $50, 3 hours minimum, so $150 you're going to spend without even getting to know the woman.
There's so much more I'd rather spend $150 on.
But, you know, but you might hit it off with the winged woman. That's, you never know, right?
You never
it's
know.
A cheap escort
there's
service.
There's three choices.
New York only.
New York, oh, yes. Dan says it's available in New York only. How does Dan know all this stuff? He was very
Adam
excited about this
segment. Adam told him on his Friendster
list. That's right. That is it.
Oh.
Sarah?
Okay. Are you sick of munching down those TV dinners in front of your computer? Why not impress your date by turning off your computer and breaking out the chef skills? iChef.com has hundreds of easy but impressive recipes that you can throw together in a jiffy. If you've got any food-related questions, just type them into the question bar to get your answer. They've got a sweet selection of Halloween treats, too. So for the link, go to thescreensavers.com and never, ever offer her a Hungry Man dinner again. Don't do it. Now, don't go anywhere. Do not go anywhere. Later, we'll be playing one of our favorite super addictive party games, and up next, find out what it's like to play one of the oldest computer games ever made on a vintage computer from the 60s, which is like so long ago, when hippies were still ruling them. When the screensavers continue.
F-16. Hornet. F-111.
The Acura RSX Type S, now with 210 horsepower. You'll know it when you hear it.
Are you getting that?
Yeah!
Are you getting that? Yeah! Get the car! Get the car!
X-Men Legends. Choose your X-Men. Combine their powers. Save a helpless planet. X-Men Legends, rated T for teen.
Why did your last diet fail?
If you're over 30, overstressed, and overweight, take a look in the mirror. You've got excess body fat around your waist, hips, and belly, right? Well, diet failure is not your fault. The problem is cortisol, a nasty little stress hormone that traps excess fat around the middle. But now, there's Relicor. Relicor helps control cortisol and helps us lose stubborn belly fat fast. If you're dieting and still plagued by unsightly belly bulge, even if you're low-carb dieting, there's only one Relicor. Relicor helps you get thinner, look younger, and have energy to burn. Remember, when you're over 30, overstressed, and want to get rid of stubborn belly fat, the answer is Relicor. Order Relicor now. It's easy. You'll love it.
Order Relicor risk-free. Call 1-800-477-1830. That's 1-800-477-1830. Call now. It's guaranteed.
Watch, play, win. Hyperactive!
We have a new online game everyone is talking about.
Every weeknight, while you watch X-Play and Unscrewed with Martin Sargent, go online and play Hyperactive along with the shows. You can win an iPod Mini and other cool stuff. Go to g4techtv.com/hyperactive and play along every weeknight at 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific. The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge is heating up.
The sticks got hotter than fish grease.
And emotions are boiling over as the nation's best Madden gamers lay it on the line for a shot at 50 G's.
This game, it ain't no game.
Get caught up on all the action with the Madden Challenge Halftime Update, Saturday night at 10:30.
Welcome back to the Screensavers. I'm Kevin Rose. Coming up in this half hour, Tina's got a review of one of her favorite party games, Super Monkey Ball 2. Plus, we're going to play Mystery Bag or Netcam. Audience, who wants to play that? And Sarah's got a sneaky tip for hiding your hard, keeping your hard drive hidden. Now, the first computer I ever owned was a Packard Bell 286 SX16. It's probably in the trash now, but our next guest collects all this stuff and actually runs the Vintage Computer Festival. Please welcome Salam Ismail. Hey, welcome to the show. So, Well, tell us about the Vintage Computer Festival. What is that exactly?
Okay, it's a celebration of computers and computer history. I've been holding it for, this is the seventh event now. It's been going on for 8 years. We have events all over the world now. Mm-hmm. And it's basically what it is, a celebration of computers and history. I have speakers talk about different aspects of computer history, different eras, different machines. We have a number of exhibits, different collectors from all over the world come and exhibit different computers from their collections. And then we have a little marketplace, and then there's trivia games and stuff like that.
That's interesting. So did you guys take over like an auditorium somewhere? How big is it now? How many people attend?
Last year we had over 550 people, and it's been hosted for the last 3 years by the Computer History Museum in Mountain View. So it's at the museum. People get to go on tours of the artifacts while they're there, as well as, you know, do all the exhibits of the Vintage Computer Festival itself. So it's a great experience.
Do you ever have anybody come up and just like, this is just a bunch of junk. Why are you guys doing this? Like, it's old computers that don't even work half the time.
I rarely hear that. Once in a while, some people just don't get it.
And, right.
But no, it's mostly people are just like, wow, that is the coolest thing I've ever seen. I didn't know, you know, computers were that old. That's usually the experience you get.
So what are some of the coolest stuff that you see that people bring in? Is there anything that you've seen that's like, wow, this was the first of this, or this is something I've never seen before?
Well, there's been a lot of that. There's been a lot of like one-off things that people brought in, really rare things, but I really get off on the stuff that people create, like the recreations of old computers, replicas, simulators, things like that. Those are the things that I really like to see more of, because it kind of, you know, we don't have a lot of people doing tinkering these days like they did, you know, a few decades ago.
Right.
And I'd like to kind of see that come back, and so that's kind of what really gets me going.
So do you have people taking like the old code off the chips and like creating and soldering brand new boards and creating these replicas and selling them, or do they just keep them for their private collection?
Well, a good example is one person has done a replica of the Apple I, the first Apple, because those are like impossible to find.
Right.
And if you do, they're, you know, sell for thousands of dollars. So he built a functional replica of the Apple I. And then other people they're resurrecting machines. You know, they're actually taking machines that were just rusted out, you know, hulks of metal, and cleaning them up, getting the code running again. And not only that, they go beyond that. They preserve it by dumping the ROM so that, you know, they have that for posterity, documenting the system in different
right.
ways, collecting everything. So collecting is also part of actually being, you know, an amateur historian or archivist,
right.
because now you're maintaining something for history.
Now, speaking of collecting, I purchased this on eBay here just probably about a year and a half ago for $350. This is Windows 1.0 sealed in the original box. Now, are you seeing a lot of people doing this type of thing, or where they're buying old computer parts as like kind of like a comic books type thing, where they're collecting?
Oh, right. Well, I don't like that analogy, because, you know, we all saw what happened to comic books. But
right.
with computers, yeah, I mean, it definitely reached kind of a fad era about a year ago or mm-hmm. so, and it's since then it's kind of died down a little bit. You saw a lot of prices really jumping, and that kind of coincided with the dot-com boom and all these geeks having money, and then
right.
now that all the, you know, money's dried up, you don't see these stuff you know, selling for those ridiculous amounts
right.
of money anymore. But yeah, I mean, it definitely is something where people are going out and collecting because they appreciate the history of them. They want to create their own collection.
Very cool. So what did you bring for us today? What is this?
Okay, so this is the front panel of a replica of a PDP-1 computer. This was Digital Equipment Corporation's first computer, designed in 1960.
Wow.
And I actually designed a replica that was commissioned by the National Science Museum of Japan. And that's installed right now. It's on display in their History of Video Games exhibit.
Right.
And so this is a second one that I created for a demonstration. And what it's doing right now is it's actually, this is what the machine actually looks like. Right now on this laptop is running a simulator of the PDP-1. And the simulator, I got to give credit to Bob Supnick, who's the guy that designed the simulator. And he actually created this whole project called the Computer History Project, where he explores computer history by simulating the actual machines. And then the graphics portion of it was made by a guy named Phil Budney.
Uh-huh.
And so those guys really deserve credit for the functionality of the actual simulator.
And then we have controllers right here. So what we're going to be doing today is playing, is this the first game that was ever created?
This is the first video game. As far as everyone knows, it's well documented. These controllers actually are built that are modeled after drawings and recollections of people who actually played it back at MIT. And I took the dimensions from old photographs that I saw and kind of recreated them. So these are pretty accurate.
These are terrible controllers.
Well, they're actually really comfortable when you play them.
Like big boxes.
The top is to y'all. Yaw left and yaw right.
Okay.
The thrust is you pull down. To hyperspace, you push up, and then fire is the
opposite. So we can fire it up. So what? So here it is right here. This is the first
right.
thing. It's like asteroids,
so
right?
So it looks like, okay, yeah. So what you have to do, when you first start off, you want to kind of turn to the right or left and then thrust for a little bit so that you can get away from the gravity star, because the gravity star is always pulling you in. So you're the what's called the wedge. You're right there,
right.
The thinner guy.
I'll take this over Doom 3 any day of the week.
This is actually really fun. It was really challenging. The whole purpose of doing the controllers, see, initially they used to play the game on the switches on the front panel.
Right.
And then after they destroyed, a bunch of switches, they decided it would probably be a lot easier to, build these controllers. And so that's where these came about.
Very cool.
Basically
well, thanks for bringing that in. That's awesome.
Yeah, no problem.
First video game. To learn more about vintage computing, take a look at the screensavers.com. We have all the information there. Now, stay where you are, because later we're going to be playing Mystery Bag or Netcam, and after the break, Tina's got a review of the super fun, super addictive game, Super Monkey Ball 2. That's all when the Screensavers continues.
Pookie pie. Do I look fat in these? Hmm? Ah, you are so sweet. Love you.
When you need a moment, chew it over with Twix.
To be absolutely sure, I'm getting the lowest prices on electronics. I feel like I need a sign from above. That'll work.
At Circuit City, you'll find unbeatable prices guaranteed on a huge selection of TVs. Like this 27-inch TV for just $157.99. Circuit City.
First there was pizza, and it was good. Then there was something entirely different. The new double melt pizza from Domino's. Layer upon layer of cheese and
crust.
Excuse
me. Do we have to do this every time we order?
Why not?
Domino's new double melt pizza. Layer upon layer of flavor. With a creamy blend of cheeses and herbs between two thin crusts. Buy your medium one topping double melt pizza for $9.99 and get any second medium for just $5 more. Get the door. It's Domino's new double melt pizza.
Relax. Only Stridex pads are alcohol-free, so you can clean your skin and fight acne without the harsh experience. Now try new essential care pads with vitamins. Stridex. Expect more.
It will summon you. It will challenge you. It will consume you. Mortal Kombat Deception. Online for PlayStation 2 and Xbox. Rated mature.
Get ready for the Digital Digs Dash. Starting November 8th, we're giving away four $25,000 shopping sprees. Go to g4techtv.com to find out more. Digital Digs Dash, brought to you by Circuit City.
Well, the next time you throw a party, you might want to fire up one of my favorite party games, Super Monkey Ball 2.
You've been talking this one up.
I have. And I'm so excited to play with you because Kevin, just so you know, is the guy at a party that doesn't let anybody leave until they do four shots of tequila.
It's true. You've been to my
party. Yeah, the taco party. And it was like, you can't leave until you do the shot of tequila. So let's bring up Super Monkey Ball.
You're allergic, isn't it?
I am allergic to tequila.
Yeah, likely story.
Look, let me kick your butt. Okay, ready? So this is a Sega game. Really started off as a really obscure arcade game back in the day.
Okay.
And the original Super Monkey Ball launched with the GameCube title, which is why it did pretty well.
Ah.
It just got a huge, huge following. So this is the sequel. And a couple things, you've got the main game, which is sort of a single story, which you've got four monkeys who live on Monkey Island, and this like Dr. Ban Ban or Bon Bun, or I forget his name.
Bam Bun.
Comes in with a giant vacuum and sucks up all the bananas from all the monkeys. They're like, oh no, they've got they got our bananas. So now they got to save them, and they go through all these levels, and it's a lot of fun.
Wow.
But what do we want? We want the party
let's
game,
Let's go to the
right?
party game. Let's play.
Let's go to the party game, and let's do my favorite, which is Super Monkey Target. Okay, so the objective of this is to score more points than I am.
Okay, I haven't played this yet.
Okay, here are the four characters. Nini, Baby, Gon Gon. Okay, so.
Gon Gon.
Okay, so you're going to do two players.
Okay.
All right, and I'm going to be Baby.
Okay, I'm Gon Gon.
Okay, and let's go ahead and start the game. So the objective, all you're going to need to do is use your analog stick to roll the ball down and the A button to open up your wings.
Well, hold on. Which stick to do what?
This one.
Okay.
Okay, ready? So you're going to push it forward.
All right.
Okay, so I'm red.
Whoa.
Okay, and now you're going to hit the wings. Hit the wings. Hit it. And you fell out.
I don't understand.
Okay, let's try it. Okay, we both just totally blew on that. Okay, okay, you're gonna go straight down. It's just hard a little. Okay,
okay,
ready?
So I'm in a ball and I'm flying, but.
No, you don't hit the ball. Oh.
Whoa, I'm flying.
Okay, flying, but okay.
I'm in the air.
So the objective,
Kevin. I'm in a ball again.
Kevin, see ya? Okay. Okay. But see the monkey on top?
I'm stuck on the slide and I can't move.
Okay, so the objective here is to try and get as close to the target and as many bananas as you possibly can.
This sucks.
Kevin, let me tell you how much I love this game. It's addictive. As you can see, you're stuck.
Why can't I move? You would think you'd let him do something.
Do you know what that means? It means I win, Kevin Rose. I think it means I win. But, you know, we could take
this back. Is a GameCube game. It's for little kids, after all. I'm not really that best at these. I'm more of the Xbox man myself.
Yeah,
but,
I hear you. All right. Well, I could kick your ass all day, but there's other stuff to get done.
Trash talking.
Sarah, what do we have coming up?
Ooh, coming up after the break, we're going to be playing Mystery Bag or Net Cam. It's the funnest time you will ever have. I want to keep a drive on your computer hidden from everybody else. I have an easy solution coming up next.
So you back on the block, huh? Yeah, yeah, it's good to see you back.
Theft Auto, San Andreas, coming October 26th on PlayStation 2, rated M for mature. Unleash the power of a worldwide phenomenon.
Welcome back, Dr. Jackson.
Packed with all new extras. Stargate SG-1 Season 7 on DVD today. Own the entire collection on DVD now.
Chief, next.
I should be hosting X-Play. Not you, you're just an actor. Adam Sessler. To him, Atari is just like a cool t-shirt that he wears to look cool, like he plays video games a lot. Well, he doesn't. Morgan Webb, though, she plays video games. She understands.
Obsessed with video games? Watch X Play. Tonight at 11.
Sorry, sir. Your credit card's been declined.
Are you one of the millions of Americans with $2,000 or more in credit card debt? Would you like to cut your monthly payments by as much as half? Credit Guard of America can help.
At Credit Guard of America, they analyze your total unsecured debt and give you the best solution that fits your needs.
Credit Guard's money management solutions even include credit counseling.
Credit Guard helped me with my home equity loan.
They helped with my IRS problems.
And my debt settlement.
Credit Guard even gave me free counseling to help with my student loan.
Whether you're current and making minimum payments, behind or about to fall behind, learn how you can achieve financial freedom with Credit Guard's free money management counseling service.
We did it!
Pick up the phone and call right now to speak to one of Credit Guard's certified credit counselors. If you're in debt $2,000 or more, Credit Guard can help you solve your financial worries.
Call 800-867-9405.
Find out what $100,000 in tech gets.
Yeah!
In the Digital Digs Makeover Special, only on G4 Tech TV.
Your life is going to completely change.
I'm pumped. Let's go.
Watch as we hit the winner's house with 100 G's of gear, gadgets, and gigabytes. The Digital Digs Makeover Special, Sunday night at 10. Brought to you by Circuit City and Yahoo.
Be sure to catch tomorrow's show. We'll be firing up the microwave to bring you the worst TV dinners we've ever tasted. Plus tips for taking better looking digital photos, and we're going to turn a photo into a 3D image.
Talented bunch of people, aren't you, over
here? We have the technology. That's all on tomorrow's show.
Well, Kevin, do you know what time it is?
I don't know, audience.
It's that time, you'll be glad, it's the funnest time you'll ever had. We raided the lab and our pantry too, it could be a twig or a CPU. It's the mystery bag or netcam.
All right! Tina, go get us all the
questions! All right, looking for an audience member here! You two, come on up. You guys are brothers. No, no, no. You guys are brothers?
No, no, we're brothers.
All right, you guys got to stay. Sorry. You guys are... All right, we got our guy over here. Let's go.
All right. All right.
All right. We got to check out his shirt, Kevin. It's
the brother's
awesome.
Crying in the audience now.
I know. I just...
Oh, he's okay. He's okay.
I'll send you Super Monkey Ball 2, I promise.
Nice. What's up?
Oh, I got my
Look
shirt.
At this.
I always pick the mystery bag.
He always picks the mystery bag. That's awesome. Now, the game is simple, okay? You can choose either this brand new Logitech cam right here. This is the Zoom cam. This is actually a really nice net cam. It's valued about like $70. It zooms, tracks the user. No, it's a really high-end net cam. So we actually get the replacement from the jank ones that we used to give out.
All right, what's your name, by the way?
My name is Timo.
Where are you from?
I'm from Santa Monica.
All right, obviously a screensaver fan. I always pick mystery bag. Kevin, I think this is going to be a pretty easy one.
Yes, I think I know what he's going to pick. But here is the mystery bag. Now, just a little glimpse of what might be in there.
Oh, sweet.
So you don't know. Which one is it going to be?
Mystery bag.
Mystery bag,
yeah!
It is. Open it up and let's see what's in there. Beanie Baby. There's something else though. There's something else. Let's take a look.
Uh-oh.
G4ia bag.
It looks pretty.
Open it up. What is it? Look at that. Brand new video card. GeForce FX 5700 LE. It's overclocked and ready to go.
All right. What do you say to Kevin?
Thank you so much.
Not a problem. Okay. Thanks for being on the show.
All right,
excellent.
Thank
Audience,
you.
Audience, give him a big round of applause.
Thank you, guys.
Take it off, too. We'll save these bags for next week.
That's cool. I got to send those two kids a game because I was like, that was so.
Here, give those kids a net cam.
Yeah.
The kids that, give them
All right,
net cam.
I'm going to go run and give these kids a net cam.
Courtesy of Logitech, we're going to give them, since they thought they were going to play, but then they couldn't.
All right, hand back the net cam. There you guys
there
go.
There we go. Everybody wins here on the screensavers. That was fun.
Oh, wait, the guy.
You gave it to the wrong people. You should give it
to
the wrong people.
No, you're supposed to pass it down. Pass it back.
Aww. That's too bad.
Oh, my God.
Let's see what kind of sneaky stuff Sarah has going on over here.
Tina's like a see-through, like, I hate kids. Okay, so this is a fun little trick. I did this sometime last year, and I have a lot of people still asking me about it. So I decided, let's bring it back. It's how to hide a drive on your computer.
Ooh, that is sneaky.
Now, it's not just your hard drive. It's any drive. You know, you could assign many different parts of your hard drive or other...
Thumb drives.
Anything. You've got A through Z. Those are your possibilities, cool. Right? So I'm looking at my computer, and it's like, well, it looks like all I've got is a C drive here, right? On my laptop here. Mm-hmm. But I happen to know full well that I have a DVD drive, which is my D drive.
Mm-hmm.
Why isn't that showing up? Let's say it's like, okay, well, maybe it's a My Computer fluke, right? So I'll just open up Windows Explorer. No, not seeing it anywhere. Now, what's the deal? Now, let's say I go to, because I happen to know that I've got something in there, and I look, well, there it is.
Ah.
And in fact, it's got a CD in it.
But it was
and
hidden.
It's got music, but it's hidden. And it's hidden from anybody who's just casually looking on your system.
That's awesome. So
which is important.
If you have friends that you really want to screw with, install this on their computer when they're not around, and then hide their drives.
And the nice thing is that there's nothing to install. Zero, zip, zilch.
It's a
registry tweak. And I'm not going to go through the details because it's kind of involved. But the whole point of it is that your drives all have decimal values, okay? Now, in my article, I explain this very thoroughly. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, that's okay. You can do it step by step later. But I'll show you real quickly. And they increase exponentially. Like A is 1, B is 2, C is 4, okay. D is 8, and so on and so forth, right?
Okay.
And what you can do is in your registry editor, let's just say I wanted to hide my D drive, I'm just giving it a value of 8. As you can see, there's an 8 in here. I've done it correctly. It's sort of you modify the
nice.
Value of your key folders and so on and so forth. And so 8 is hidden. Now you say, okay, well it comes in really handy because let's say you wanted to put all of your financial documents on your H drive.
Right, but you don't want people to see that they're there.
Something like that. Yeah,
cool.
And it just, no one will ever know that
Excellent.
It exists. Really cool. Now, of course, you can search for the H drive itself.
Right.
It exists.
It's still there, just not showing up.
You can get it from the run command or command line and stuff like that, mm-hmm. but it's not going to show up in all the obvious places. Now, what if you were to say, I would like to hide my C and my D drive. You can do that. And it's really, really, it's so simple and freakish the way
you
it works.
You combine the values?
All you do is add C and D together for a value of 12, right?
Cool.
It gets a little bit, you know, I have to do a little bit more standard arithmetic if you're going to
Or all drives, that's the sum
if
of all
If you want to do
like
all drives, if you want to actually have a system that appears to have no drives at all, the value is 67,108,863.
Nice.
But you can do it.
That's
which I
cool.
think is super fun. One last thing. People have asked me, well, can't you do that with Tweak UI? Well, I have my D drive hidden, right? And if you open up Tweak UI and you go to the My Computer area and you click on Drives. Now, someone who was wondering, do you have all your drives hidden? It appears that D is checked.
Right.
It appears that D would show up if it existed. So somebody who knows Tweak UI, still, it kind of gets past Tweak UI, too.
Ah, interesting.
So I kind of like that.
Very cool.
Isn't that fun?
That is fun.
You can get the link to the article at my website at sarahlane.com. We will have it at thescreensavers.com very soon. Steps are important, so make sure you read it carefully. Now, here we are, because we're going to check our inbox to see what's on your mind when the screensavers is here.
You'll never forget the people you hurt when you were high.
No. Nope. Mm-mm. No. You, get in the van.
It's Team Bam versus Team Hawk in Tony Hawk's Underground 2. This time, it's not just about skating, it's about mayhem. Tag it, slap it, thrash it, blast it on a totally underground, definitely illegal world destruction tour. Tony Hawk's Underground 2, rated T for Teen.
So what's the difference between Madden Football and Blitz?
They all kick touchdowns.
These We Sell Everything stores don't take games seriously. You gotta talk to gamers.
Oh, man. Blitz is like an arcade game. Helmets flying off, bodies piling up. Madden's more like being in a real game.
Sweet. Reserve the hottest new releases. Pre-owned games and equipment at big discounts. Save on new games by trading in old ones.
Ever wondered what it's really like to be a soldier?
What do you got?
I have a sit rep from Alpha Company.
PG, ready to be verified. Verified!
Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, even what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY now and get this free t-shirt and your free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
Next on G4 Tech TV, Sheep, followed by Cinema Tech at 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific, and then it's Filter.
We want to remind you that if you're in the Los Angeles area, we want you to be in our studio audience.
Yes, and you'll get the webcam.
Yes, hope you'll have to fight for a webcam. But go to thescreensavers.com and click on the tickets link, and you too can have your very own ticket to come see the screensavers completely free.
Absolutely, and don't forget to watch g4tv.com.
That's right.
Wednesdays, 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific. We've had you on. I've got a great co-host, Laura Foy, and we have a bunch of good rotating guests coming in and out, so don't forget to check it out and talk games.
Very cool. Also, I want to mention the Vintage Computer Guy. The Vintage Computer Festival 7.0 will be November 6th through the 7th, which is Saturday and Sunday. It's going to be in Mountain View, California, and you can find out more about that at vintage.org.
Sounds good. Yeah, absolutely.
Do we have time for a final email real quick?
Sure. This is from James in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. He says, I use my laptop at work and at home, but I have to keep changing the IP address for the two networks. Is there a piece of freeware or tip that would allow me to do this easier?
Oh, yeah. There's actually a great one. I'm going to let you go ahead and tell them, though.
That's a good question. It should automatically change the IP address when you plug it into a new network. When you're going between networks, that's just what Windows does. But if you want to figure out what your IP address is, you can go to ipchicken.com. It's a little strange sounding. It's a big picture of a chicken there, but it shows your current IP address.
Whatever it takes to get people to click on it.
Yeah, it works. ipchicken.com, that is the link you're going to need. We are out of time, though. That is it for this edition of The Screensavers. I'm Kevin Rose.
I'm Tina Wood. Thank you so much for joining. I forgot my name, by the way.
We'd like to thank our guest, Salam Ismail. See you next time. Have a great night. Great job.
Thank you very much.
Great job.
Had a great time.
I hate Adam Sessler.
I'd rather suck at a urinal puck than play this game.
Why does he get to play video games and review video games on our show about video games?
Why does he get to spend every day with Morgan Webb?
We've got a preview of the hottest new releases.
Yeah!
Obsessed with video games? Watch X-Play with Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb. Tonight at 11.